come to evening prayers on Monday the 2nd of May. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, again, at the end of a day, that you make sense of our lives. When we stop, when we take stock, when we look away and look to you, we know that things make sense in the light of your word, in the company of your presence. When we look elsewhere, we can be like Peter looking at the waves. Gosh, that looks difficult. Can I do it? Can I cope? When we stop and look at you, we know you are with us and that you're providing a way. That you'll hold out your hand to grab us, even if we sink. So we invite you to be part of our evening hour again. Thank you, Lord, for the times of prayer we've had over, well, months, maybe even years. And thank you that that is just like feeding on you properly. Learning from you and taking you in and, yeah, just being blessed by you. Not for just for ourselves, though it is for us, but also that others may know you. Come, Holy Spirit. We invite you again to make things, to make real the things of Jesus. And we ask this now in your name. Amen. Okay, our final foray into Corinthians. This is 1 Corinthians 3. We're just going into the early part 3, verses 1 to 9. And this is from a website called 100 Chapters.
Brothers and sisters, I could not address you as people who live by the Spirit, but as people who are still worldly, mere infants in Christ. I gave you milk, not solid food, for you were not yet ready for it. Indeed, you are still not ready. You are still worldly. For since there is jealousy and quarrelling among you, are you not worldly? Are you not acting like mere humans? For when one says, I follow Paul, and another, I follow Apollos, are you not mere human beings? What, after all, is Apollos? And what is Paul? Only servants, through whom you came to believe, as the Lord has assigned to each his task. I planted the seed, Apollos watered it, but God has been making it grow. So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who makes things grow. The one who plants and the one who waters have one purpose, and they will each be rewarded according to their own labour. For we are co-workers in God's service. You are God's field, God's building.
I once heard a preacher use this as an illustration. They said, imagine you went out to a meal. You were invited out to some fancy gig. And you went to this house. And first thing they did, they brought some bowls in. And they were full of milk. And you thought, oh, that's a bit odd. But he thought, oh, well, you know, you don't question when you're out, do you? And he thought, oh, okay. And so it's very tasty, actually. And the milk's very, you know, sustaining and fresh and cooling to the tongue. And the rest of it, oh, you have it, bowl of milk. And then the second course arrives. And it's another bowl of milk. Think to yourself, oh, huh? And because you're polite, you make your way through this. The pudding comes, as I call it, or the sweet, and, oh, right, another bowl of milk. Now, you know how ridiculous that story is. That's just, I don't know what you do in those circumstances. That's crazy. But this is what St. Paul is saying about the Corinthians. He's saying, you just live on, like, baby's milk. You can't take solid food. I remember when, you know, if you've had kids at all, you know how it is when you're moving them onto the solids. That's quite a transition. And he's saying they can't take it. They can't take meat. They can't take solids. That's so difficult, isn't it? And a simple question is simply this. Is your faith diet, yeah? Is your faith diet A round of easy food that you can swallow very easily. I love junket. Who doesn't love junket? There's not too many hands going up there. I can't make it ever these days. I used to have it when I was small. Junket slips down so quickly. Great. I don't think it sustains me a great deal, to be honest. You have to have solid food, don't you? How's our faith diet? Are we eating food that sustains us and helps us to grow? Now, that is in all kinds of ways, but certainly it's about learning. And, you know, some of that's a responsibility of the church leaders. You know, how are we providing the right level of a diet to our people? You know, preachers and ministers and, you know, preachers meeting and worship consultations, all that stuff, and in other places, in home groups and in other ways of teaching, all that stuff, resourcing the church. But some of it's a responsibility of us as the congregation. We've got to say, I actually want to know more. I want to know depth. I want to say, somebody once said to me when I was preaching, this is years ago, it's a church anniversary down in Leatherhead, where I come from. And this lady very kindly said, your sermon, Phil, is like a rich fruitcake. Or maybe she was just calling me a fruitcake. I can't remember. No, she, what she was meaning was, somehow in what I was giving them, there was a lot of riches and things to chew over, which that was a real compliment, actually. And, you know, we need that. We can't live on milk. Milk's good, but we can't live on that just all the time, spiritually speaking. I don't know if it was my last evening prayers or the one before, but I played this song, just a very short song, called Fat Baby. We'll have another song to finish with, but it tickled some people. And I'll just play it again because this is basically what that is saying. Are we just living not on solid food, but are we just becoming fat on the wrong kind of diet?
I know a man, maybe you know him too. You never can tell, he might even be you. He knelt at the altar and that was the end. He saved and that's all that matters to him. A spiritual tummy, it can't take too much. One day a week he gets a spiritual lunch. On Sunday he puts on his spiritual best and gives his language a spiritual rest. He's just a fat, he's just a fat little baby. He wants his bottle and then he told me maybe. He samples solid food with once or twice, but he says doctrine leaves him cold as ice. He's been baptized, sanctified, redeemed by the blood, but his daily devotions are stuck in the mud. He knows the books of the Bible and John 3:16. He's got the biggest King James ever seen. I've always wondered if he'll grow up someday. He's mama's boy and he likes it that way. If you happen to see him, tell him I said he'll never grow if he never gets big. He's just a fat, he's just a fat little baby. He wants his bottle and he don't mean maybe. He samples solid food once or twice, but he says doctrine leaves him cold.
So let's pray. Father God, we know that in the Methodist Church, one of the our calling pillars is learning and caring. And Lord, sometimes we can be so stuck in what we think we know and that's all we need. And we're going hungry. We're going for sustenance. We're doing without. It isn't a rich diet. Some of that is our fault, Lord. We're not asking. Take the milk away. I want to have some food. Help us not to be satisfied with less than the best. Help us to hunger and thirst for you. Help the diet to be rich, that we might know the depths and the length and the heights that St. Paul will talk about. The great riches of Jesus, the full measure of the stature of him. And help us to take that to the world, because the world is very hungry. Help us to know there is so much more. We pray this prayer knowing that the world needs your healing and your touch and your nourishment today. Help us to be those who can do that for those around us because of Jesus. Amen. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I want to use this blessing from John Rutter as we finish this week with me. And this is, in a way, taking forward what we're talking about today. Go forth into the world, it says, in peace. And it's telling us how we can be a blessing to others. But we need to have that blessing, you know, received, that we may give out. So very nice to be with you this week, and enjoy your evening prayers from now on as well. And this is John Rutter, and I wish you a good night's rest.